Hello everyone, this is James Cox here with Premier Martial Arts in Abilene. I hope that you're all doing amazing, and I just wanted to take a moment here to discuss a couple of topics that I have on my mind. This is because I've had some conversations here recently with some people, and these two things have came up, so they're interesting, and hope it can add some value, if not some education and motivation for you, not only in martial arts, but again, it's all about a way of life as well. So the first topic was, which style is better? Which system, particular type of discipline of martial arts is better? Better, I mean, that's pretty broad, right? So we would want to explain that, you know, as far as effectiveness or useless or whatever the goals are for the style of martial arts that you're training or looking for. Secondly, it was belt rank promotion. That's kind of like payday, right? That can be sensitive, but can anyone become a black belt? You know, when do you earn and deserve your rank? Why is this person maybe a higher rank, but not as good as someone that's a lower rank? Or what area or what aspect? I mean, what are we talking about? These are individuals and we're all different, but still the question of belt rank and promotion. So let's talk about the first one, this style thing. I used to get this a lot with inquiries, you know, decades and decades ago, now that a lot of systems mix their styles and people are a little more educated because we have this thing called internet, then it's not as common. But which style is better? I mean, I do have to say that I really like what we do. I think it serves the purpose of my goal, is making our students well-rounded and prepared and good at everything. But mixing things like Kaju Kembo, Krav Maga, Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, Muay Thai, I like that mixture. But let's talk about, you know, which style is better, which system. Well, dude, first, what are you looking for? You know, I mean, if you want to compete in the Olympics in judo, then the only thing you need to do is judo, and that's the reason. Then you got to search for the right place with the qualified instructor where you're getting the results, seeing the progress, and happy with the outcome. You know, you can think of martial arts styles, and it also makes me think quickly of food. I mean, I'm hungry, I guess, but I also like food. But when you think of food and all the different types, which food is better? You know, is that just personal preference? Maybe culture, maybe mood, a lot of factors, right? So if it's American, Asian, Mexican, Italian, which food is better? Then let's think about this. What about the same types of food, even the same specific dish, but it can taste so different? What makes it different? The chef, the ingredients, the order of the ingredients, the method, the systems of how it was cooked and delivered, of course, right? I mean, if you want some lasagna at an Italian restaurant, maybe there's two restaurants next to each other, and they can taste so different. One can be amazing, it was perfect, you loved every bit of it, the other one is disgusting and makes you sick, right? You know? So you need to look at your styles maybe in those ways. Preference, what are the goals and what are you looking for? I always recommend, you know, you shop around, you try it out. It's a big decision. But do you have enough self-awareness on what you're looking for? Are you wanting to compete? Then make sure the school is a competitive school. You know, or are you just wanting fitness? Then make sure you're going to, you know, burn calories and get the strength and the flexibility and the things for good fitness. You know, is all about the life skills, confidence, respect. I mean, because certain places specialize in certain things, of course. But you choose your martial arts style by being aware, knowing your goals, trying it, and seeing what kind of progress that you gain from it. It's hard to say that styles are better than others, but they are, depending on what you're looking for. And unfortunately, there's a lot of trash out there, you know? But is it the style, or once again, is it the instructor? You know, how hard did he work, you know? What's his lineage, and how did he or she earn their rank, and what kind of black belts are they producing of quality, you know, or not? I mean, I've been around and I've seen some really good and really bad of everything, you know. I've seen some Taekwondo, some Kaju Kembo, some every style there is, for the most part, that was not very good. And then I've seen some that was amazing. So it wasn't as much the style as it was, you know, the instructor. Although you can do some research on what you're looking for specifically, and then you look at the quality of the teaching. Yeah. So I think that's really it about the style thing, you know. Bruce Lee has said something about, you know, take what is useful, reject what is useless, you know, be a creative individual and, you know, find what's going to work for you and what you can evolve with. I would say if the style's not evolving, it wouldn't be something that I would want to be a part of. I mean, unless it's just just for the tradition, for the art, for the fitness, but I would really look at something that is evolving because things change and people fight differently and people attack differently. And, you know, a lot of times simple is just better nowadays for certain. So I don't know, get in where you fit in, try it out, have fun. Second topic. So we were talking about, I was talking about belt rank promotion. Can anyone become a black belt? I mean, immediately I say no. And that's just because anyone is a pretty broad topic, right? Anyone, I mean, you know, but becoming a black belt and the journey of the black belt, the journey is always more important than the destination, right? You know, it can be life-changing. It can be a ton of success and things that someone can develop that puts them at a higher level than they ever thought was possible. Can they become the best version of their self? So can you be a black belt or train like a black belt when you're not even one yet? Sure, you know, that's just reaching for the top and not giving up and, you know, doing your very best and everything. You get out of it what you put in it, right? But belt ranks, you know, depending on the style and how many belt ranks they have, man, there's so many of those early on belt ranks that are not that different, but people need short-term goals and people need, you know, achievements and progression. So if, you know, your yellow belt is not as good as an orange belt, well, does it really matter? Now, what I would look at is as we're getting closer to black belt, there should be some significant difference. You know, you also got to look at the individual in mind. I mean, you may not know their stories, man. I mean, first, with all respect, within an academy, it's not really your business. You should worry about yourself if you're the student or the parent of that student and, you know, train hard and learn and get something out of it and support the team and have the trust in the instructor, you know. But of course, nothing should be watered down. Nothing should be the mech dojo of just handing belts out, but it should be earned and deserved. But if someone earns a belt, and they're a different person. And again, you don't know their story, man. You don't know what they've been through. You don't know their learning disabilities. You don't know, you know, the physical challenges that they may have. But how much did they progress to get from one belt rank to the other? Maybe they're just not the best at kickboxing, but they're amazing at jiu-jitsu. Maybe their jiu-jitsu, they just can't get it yet. They will eventually. At least they'll get better at it, I would hope. But their history, their discipline, their dedication, their focus is, you know, top notch, right? So there's a lot of areas to look at when promoting someone. I have a black belt that we used to tease a lot. He used to tease me a lot, this and that. We had a saying that it was pretty simple, shut up and train. And it was to worry less about the politics or other people and just, you know, be yourself and get in there and work hard and just shut up and train. He actually made me a sign that was in Chinese characters and that's what it said. So it was on the wall, nobody really knew what it meant but me. But, you know, it meant a lot that the focus should be on the training and the belt doesn't matter as much. Does the belt make the person or does the person make the belt? You know, now levels and comparisons, it's like comparing people, we're all different. But I think that you're gonna get out of what you put in it and, you know, you train hard and you understand, you have fun. And, you know, most of the times, most people can become a black belt. I've had people get their black belt. I've never promoted anyone under 3 years, you know, even that came in already as black belts in other styles, you know. I respect that humility to start from the beginning and work your way up. And then I've had people take 15 years to get their black belt. So it's all different and it's based on that individual and what they do with it. But anyway, I hope that helps. I'm just kind of blabbing here, but nice talk, guys. Have a good one.